this is Sorinthia 212. I'm coming in here really quick to show you what's for dinner and how I'm going to make it. Now, this I'm just experimenting with this. I never did this before. What I did was I made some jasmine gluten-free rice. What I did was I added some teriyaki sauce and some coconut oil to the rice, and I cooked it till it was al dente. Now I spread it out on a cookie sheet just to cool down while I'm gonna make what I'm gonna make. Here we have the broccoli straws. This is raw broccoli and carrots and raw cabbage that I bought the other day. I think I did a video showing y'all the bag. This right here is the leftover from the vegan tacos that I made the other day. What we have in here is peppers. We have pineapples, we have mushrooms, and you just basically just season your vegetables the way that you like. And the sauce, I believe at the time that I made, I think I had put some salsa in here. I think I also put some taco seasoning and then some Mrs. Dash seasonings, if I can remember. Let's go here. Here we have two avocados. Here I have some, just some wraps. I have a flour tortilla wrap. I have the garlic and pesto wrap. And I also have the sun-dried tomato wrap. And today, when I went out to take my daughter to the DMV, they also had a Asian store around it, which was really good because I was looking for some seasoned seaweeds. This particular kind here, you get 5 packs, and in each pack is 5 sheets of seaweed sheets, Inori seaweed sheets. So this is the way it looks, and it's roasted already and seasoned already. This is lightly seasoned with some oil and some salt. So it came like that. So this is what the package looks like, and I got a really good deal. For 25 sheets was only $8.99, which is extremely an awesome price. I also got some seaweed snacks that came in an individual package, which was 10 came in a package. 10 of them came in a package. And they were only $5.99. So you get 10 seaweed snack packages. I think about 10 of them came in a pack, and for $5.99 was just amazing, because for each pack on my college campus is $2, and you get less than what they gave me in the other package. If I can remember, I'll show you what they look like. The only thing with the Asian stores, they didn't have any different type of flavors. They just had roasted kind with the sea salt and oil on it. I was going to say something, but I can't remember. And they did not have just the plain nori sheets, to where I could have just made it myself, because I would have loved to found some raw ones and just season it the way that I like. But I'm still going to continue to look for it. But these look pretty good. They taste pretty good. So my plan, now this is experimental, y'all. My plan is to, because once I put the ingredients in here, because this is already roasted, when you try to fold it, it's going to break, or it's going to, the liquids from this is going to just soak through and just be a mushy mess. So what I'm thinking that I'm going to do is take one of these wraps here, and then take the seaweed and put on top of the wrap, and then put my ingredients, and then roll it up, and then just slice it, and my kids can dip whatever sauce they want. I have some teriyaki sauce. I also have some teriyaki dip, which is much thicker than the regular teriyaki sauce that comes in the bottle. I'll show y'all that. And I made a mistake when I had bought, what I thought I was buying was teriyaki sauce. I had also bought some soy sauce. I'm not gonna eat that because that just has too much sodium in it, and it'll give me a headache, and it's made from fish, so I'm not gonna eat it, but I don't want it to go to waste. I can't return it back to the store for the simple fact is the store where we went is about an hour and a half to 2 hours away, and I'm not about to get on the bus to be returning one item 2 hour ride, so that's not happening. So I'm gonna come back. I have to do this in bits and pieces because on this tablet you can't, which is really weird, you can't pause the video and then continue from where you picked up. So I have to like say what I have to say, then cut it off, and then come back with another video and just put them together. Okay, so I'll be right back.
I took some of the avocados and I sliced them, put some lemon on it, and I put some Goya Perfect seasoning on it. So here we have the garlic wrap, and I'm going to put I think I'm gonna probably cut it, like fold it in half. Remember, y'all, I'm just experimenting. I'm gonna fold it in half, and then I'm going to just put my ingredients on it and then just roll it. But before I do that, I want to show you the snacks that I was telling you about, the seaweed snacks. You get 10 in a pack for $5.99, and the sodium in this is very, very low. This is the 10 grams of sodium that's in here. So this is the ingredients that you can see. This was an excellent, excellent price. I got two different brands. This is the first brand that I got. And the second brand is this one. So this one tastes better than the one that I just showed you. So 10 packs come in here, and these are $5.99 a pack. I'm looking for the ingredients. So I didn't open this yet. This pack I didn't open yet. But this one right here, I believe, is 3 grams of sodium, if I'm not mistaken. So these are the sauces that I was talking about. Now, good thing I forgot that this... Why isn't this showing up? Okay. This brand here does not use fish products. So this is water and soybean salt, sodium. So this is just all the ingredients. So I can use this, but I won't, because you see how much sodium is in 920 milligrams of sodium? That shit will give me a fucking headache. I use some, it's hard recording from this camera. I have some lemon that I put on the avocado, and this is the teriyaki dipping sauce. You can marinate this. Like, I would take this and marinate it, some tofu in it, and then I would just sear tofu up, or you can use it as a dip. So let me show you. So you can marinate, you can cook with it, and you can use it as a dipping. And this is by World Harbors. So this is what it looks like. And then this is my old standby. I love this one too. So I'm gonna come back and we're gonna set up. I don't know how I'm gonna do this because I'm recording off my tablet, and I meant to do it sideways so you don't get those black bars on the side. So I'm gonna come back. So I'm back. So I took the nori sheet and I just cut it up in half and just put one long way and one widthwise. I took the rice, remember this rice, I put some teriyaki sauce and some coconut oil, and then I just cooked it. You just use the regular instructions that it says to use to make rice, but I made mine a little bit al dente to give it a little bite. I didn't want it to be like mushy. So I'm going to now, I'm gonna make different types. So this one is going to just be the garlic wrap with the nori sheets and the rice, and then I'm just going to take some of my avocado and just place some avocado on there. And then the thing I like about the broccoli straws is it's kind of bitter, so you will get like a crunch but with a kind of a bitter taste to it. And then I'm just going to wrap it, so I'll be right back. I'm sorry to keep saying I'm gonna be right back, but I'm only, but maybe I can do it without having to do that. No, I'll be right back. Okay, y'all, just know this is the first time that I'm trying to do this, but I was able to wrap some of them up in the nori sheets. So this is how the garlic wrap one came out.
We have some rice and some avocado with this one. And then the same with this one. We have some rice and some avocado. Now this one is the roasted, the sun-dried tomato roasted one. I have a nori sheet here, and the trick is not to have your nori sheet become so soggy. It's to put like something between, a barrier between it. So I have the rice, I have some of the vegan sauce here, and then I have some avocado. So I'm going to roll this. I don't think I can do it on camera, because I'm, like I said, I'm on the corner with one hand. So I'm going to roll it, and then I'm going to cut it, and I'm going to come
back. Here is the final result of the vegan sushi. So I just wanted to show you it.
Okay. Good evening, this is Serenthy212, and I am sweating my butt off. It is so hot in New York. It's about 90 something degrees, but the humidity is what gets you in New York. It's not so much of the temperature, it's the humidity. So it's like 91, but it feels like it's like 100 and goddamn 10 or 15. So anyway, I did some vegan sushi, first time making it. I did okay. I think as time go on, I'll do a little bit better. But let me show you what it looks like. So, look at y'all, I didn't fail. I don't know how I'm gonna show it to y'all. Y'all remember, I'm recording off my tablet, so please forgive me. So, this is the vegan sushi. This is a tomato wrap with the nori sheet around it, with some rice and some avocado and some sauteed vegetables and stuff that I just used the leftover ingredients that I had for the vegan tacos that I used the other day. We also have it without the nori sheet. So this is the teriyaki rice. The avocado, teriyaki rice, avocado, and I think sauteed vegetables, if I'm not mistaken. This right here is with the nori sheet. I wrapped it in a nori sheet. This is rice and the avocado. So, and then I have extra slices of avocado because I don't want it to go bad. What I used with the ingredients, like I said, was the rice, the sauteed vegetables, and I also have some broccoli straws. I think the other day I showed y'all what that was. And then I have some teriyaki sauce with some ginger. So that's what you see at the bottom of here. I took some ginger and some teriyaki sauce. So, and it tastes really, really good. Then I had a taste for some fruit. So I have some blueberries. And then just water, because it's hot. It's really, really hot. Okay, so let's try. Now the thing I noticed about the nori sheets, this is the roasted nori sheets that already is seasoned. Is that I noticed that if they sit for too long, the texture kind of changes. So I'm gonna dip it in here and let's try it. Mmm. Oh wow. That's really, oh, look at y'all. Y'all see my scarf coming apart? I'm sorry. One thing I noticed, that the nori sheets become a little hard to chew. I guess because they're wet. And they've been sitting for a while, but the flavor tastes really good. Not bad. I like the the seaweed, like fish flavor from it. I like that. It tastes like the sea. So I guess if you vegan or vegetarian, you want like a nice fish flavor, get some nori sheets. So I'm not really too good at eating with chopsticks, y'all. So I'm trying to pick up. I'm trying to pick up the tortilla wrap one. Oh my God. I think I'm just gonna wind up picking it up with my fingers. Cause it's really hard. Okay. So this one is the tortilla wrap. The flour tortilla wrap. Why the hell did I do that? Why did I pull that? Anyway, we're just gonna do it with my fingers. This is the one that's wrapped in the tortilla, flour tortilla wrap with the nori sheets, the teriyaki rice, and just avocado. So. I know that I'm not going to eat all of these because I know I'm going to get full really, really, really fast. And then I dropped it in the damn sauce by mistake. So now it's drenching in the teriyaki sauce. Look what I did, y'all. By mistake. Anyway, let's try it. Mmm. Mmm, really good. Actually, it's easier to eat the nori sheets when it's wrapped in this bread wrap. It's actually much more easier to chew the nori sheets. And then we have some avocado. I seasoned the avocado with Goya Perfect Seasoning and some lemon. So. Really good. The rice is really good too. You see the video that I talked about the rice and stuff. I'm just trying to do something different because it's just too hot to turn on the oven. To be trying to make something in the oven. Okay, so here we have the roasted tomato wrap. This doesn't have a nori sheet in it. And this is just rice and cucumbers. Rice and the broccoli slaw. So it's like broccoli and carrots and stuff in it. So let me try it without the teriyaki sauce. I love teriyaki sauce. I'm gonna think anything tastes good with teriyaki sauce. So let's just try it without teriyaki sauce. Mmm. You got the creaminess of the avocado. Mmm. And the crunch of the raw vegetables. Pretty good. We have a nice smoky taste. And like roasted tomato taste from the wrap. And I think that's all I'm going to eat. So I ate quite a bit with the wrap. That's all I'm gonna eat with the wrap. I'm just gonna have one more piece of avocado. Which avocado is amazing. I love avocado. So this is what's left. So I ate quite a bit. because the wraps are very, very big. So, and I have a taste for some fruit. These are cold, so tastes really good. But I guess that's just, like I said, I just wanted to make something different than what I'm normally making, because I'm forever making vegan tacos because they're easier. They're just easy to make. The kids aren't too keen on tofu, so I'm just constantly trying to come up with things to make for them. So I thought about this when we went to the Asian store today. Devon liked it. Of course, y'all know ain't Junior eating none of it. And Allie sleeps, so once she get up, I have her taste it. But that's it. Anyway, I'm gonna go because it's hot as hell in this kitchen. And so that was dinner for me. It's really too hot to eat too much, and to eat like heavy food, it's just too much. It's too hot. So maybe I'll see if Devon wants that, because I made him his own plate, like this huge plate, and by the time I sat down to do this video, he was finished, so he liked it. Yeah, that's it. I'm drinking my water, and I'm gonna go. So, water never tastes so good. So, thank you so much for watching, and remember to say good morning, good evening, good night to someone with a smile. It'll definitely brighten their day, evening, or night, and God bless you all.